Now in the next case, we have created this particular part. How about making it a centrally aligned? We can use practically text align in this particular case. Or say if we say here text center and press Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload, you can see that this text is now placed into the centralized position. So this is how you can create contents. You can practically lay your text elements at the middle of that particular container. Now we will be discussing on some behavioral display properties. Those we will be observing here right now. For say, if we get back to their official website, in this particular layout category, you can see that right below this container tab, there goes the display tab. So if we now click on it, we will be reaching to this particular container or display level elements. Various kind of displays been provided over here, like this block or inline block, inline flats. Those are practically various kind of display properties as been executed by Tailwind CSS. Now in the first case, we will be using this block property to create a block level element inside. In that case, you can see that div class bgray has been used as a mother wrapper in the first case, and inside we will be using some span classes, and we will be using all those properties. So right now, if we just copy this thing and paste it into our project, replace this one, let's make it a little bit of intended to stay organized. There it goes. Now everything is in order. So if we now get back to our project and reload, we can see that this will be the result. And in this particular device display width, or in smaller device display widths, everything will be displayed in a block level manner. So this is what we can observe over here. Rotate, there it goes. For say, make it 640 pixels, there it goes. So everything will be a block level element if we use this particular block property right over here. Now, instead of doing this, if for say we put here inline block property, so what will be the result? Let's have a look on it. There it goes. This is the inline block element. Get back to your project and reload. So everything now is in an inline block condition. Those are practically having a blockular shape, and those are having a side by side. Let's get back to the original preview, desktop preview, and we can see that this will be the result. Now in the similar fashion, instead of inline block, if we now use over here inline property, so what will be the result? Just remove this block property right from here, get back to your project and reload, and you can see that this will be the result. It is now getting in line, but it is now losing its blockular shape, as we can see right over here. In the next case, we can see that we are using display flex property. Now, the first thing that you need to do, if you are putting something in a display flex, and if you want that the child elements, those should be appearing side by side, horizontally side by side, then all you need to do, you need to apply the display flex property to the parent container only. So which one is the parent element over here? Is it this one? Definitely not this one. This is the parent element under which this child elements are appearing. So all we need to do, we need to remove these inline properties first from here. First of all, save it, get back to your project and reload. Nothing will happen. Now all we need to do, we need to put here this flex property. If we get back to our project, we can see that this will be the result. All we can do, we can make some specific MX4 for say, there it goes. Reload, and you can see that this will be the result. Everything is now in side by side situation. So we can say that all those elements inside, this is the parent flex container inside which these child elements, those are now in a horizontal side by side display, as we have set the parent element under a flex condition. All we had done, we had provided some horizontal margin, that means a margin left, both a margin left and a margin right of 4 class. That means if we get here, 1 REM will be the exact spacing between all of these child elements, which is equivalent to 16 bits. So everything has been provided right over here. All we need to do, we need to use them into our project. Okay, now in the next case, we will be concerning about the table element property. Get back to their official website, get back to the display. Rest of all those things are practically similar in manner. All you need to do, you need to use all those specific classes. So instead of span classes, you may use here some kind of div elements. There it goes. I think it would have been a prominent thing to use a span, a div element instead of a span element to prove that all those things are assigned, are aligned side by side. Get back to your project reload. You can see that this will be the result forever, because you have used this div class flex right over here. Now on the other hand, if we get back to their official website, these are the list of all those display properties been executed over here. So among them, let's concentrate about this table and this responsive property.